Good morning.
Good morning.
Who can finish this line for me? The sun always shines. There are storms north of here. There are storms south of here. But what do we have here? And the walk of honor outside. Congratulations, 8th grade class. Well done. Before we do this, the school hymn, I just wanted to acknowledge and welcome all alums. If there are any alums here today, please stand. I know we'll have more tomorrow. Any alums here? Excellent. Thank you so much. Thank you very much. Nice to see all of you. Grandparents, I've had the pleasure of meeting some of our grandparents this morning. Would you please stand so we can honor you and thank you for coming and attending. Thank you so much. I appreciate you being here. Parents, faculty, and friends, welcome to Awards Day. This is let me give you the whole idea of what's going to be happening. Today is a day that we honor many of our students, including, obviously, the class of 2014. We're going to find out why, truthfully, we are hopelessly devoted to you. And in order to do so, what we have is 2 days of events. Today is the awards day. Tomorrow will be the graduation day. We are going to start with the school hymn, and then for those who have not been here before, I will take the mic and I'm going to be honoring some of our great and beloved faculty members for longevity milestones, for creative sparks, and one special person who will be receiving the Courtney Martin Award. After that, Brendan will come up on the stage and he will start going through the program for our student honors. Are we set?
Yes.
All right. Mrs. Otto.
If you all stand and join our voices and sing.
Some teachers will be honored at this time, and we begin with longevity awards. We have 3 teachers who are celebrating their 10 years at Meadowbrook, and we have 2 teachers who will be celebrating 15 years at Meadowbrook. We will begin with the 10-year longevity awards. Allison Graham.
2004 to 2014, teacher of physical education, Boston Families coordinator, and all-around Meadowbrook saint. We thank you for your 10 years of community development, thoughtful support for all faculty and students, creative ideas so willingly shared with colleagues and parents, and your hard work on behalf of multicultural education and diversity. Thank you so much. Years. Brendan Largay. You have been a teacher of history, math, English, and varsity lacrosse coach. For the past 7 years, you have been the head of the middle school. You have built a middle school based on great teachers, an inspiring curriculum, and a strong community bond among students, teachers, and parents. Your middle school has earned a stellar reputation, and it is positioned to soar towards an extraordinary future. You are flexing your leadership skills and helping to create a strategic plan for Meadowbrook's future. Congratulations on building an enviable legacy in such a short amount of time. Excuse me, I have an all-points bulletin for Allison Graham. Allison Graham, would you please come up on stage? You should stay up here, please. Allison. Thank you. Balance rigor with choice time, and you are a troubadour in the advocacy for children's play. In all matters of excellence, you have stayed the course. I also want to acknowledge and give you credit for being the spouse of the school head. I think only another head spouse understands the inherent difficulties associated with your position. Well done.
Sharon Palmer. They're very interesting. They are for new ideas that are then adopted by the school, but they can't be within a person's subject matter. So it's something that is the whole school-wide atmosphere, not for example, second grade or fourth grade. And you have to be nominated by your colleagues in order to get a creative spark. First Creative Spark Award goes to John Boger.
Rodriguez,
we thank you.
you have a czarina, you have to have several great first lieutenants. Our safe, very fast dismissal is because of the work of Mia as well. We thank you very much. So we know in advance what position that parent is in the car line. That makes things much faster. That's an added duty they do as a spirit for the school, for community development. And thank you very much. So what happens when you take iPads, and with those iPads, you ask the students to be creative? Design thinking. What comes about is a tree platform that is now being built up near the woods so that you can watch all those wonderful baseball games. The person who came up with the idea of getting younger children, senior graders, first graders, second graders, involved in designing a tree platform, Jerry Hunt. Please come forward.
Courtney Martin Award for exceptional spirit, commitment, and vision for 2014. This annual award honors a teacher nominated by colleagues and chosen by the headmaster who exemplifies the qualities by Courtney Martin, Meadowbrook teacher from 2003 to 2007. These include an exceptional commitment to students, enthusiasm for teaching, imagination and creativity in and out of the classroom, a vision for the future, and most importantly, a positive spirit and outlook on life. Whether through specific classroom work, visionary school-wide programming, or mentoring, the actions of the award winner will clearly have an impact on all Meadowbrook students. The Courtney Martin Award for Exceptional Spirit, Commitment, and Vision is awarded to Dottie Corbier.
Dottie. Congratulations for being nominated by your peers for the Courtney Martin Award. Your peers said about you the following. I nominate Dottie for her ceaseless energy and excitement for new, innovative curriculum in the areas of technology and mathematics. Dottie has contributed mightily to the reputation of a Meadowbrook school and to the excitement for learning exhibited by her students. Another teacher said, Dottie is the driving force behind Story Starter, I Create to Educate, Logo, and DigiBlocks. She always has time for children who need a helping hand, and she is a national recognized trainer of teachers in mathematics, DigiBlocks, and Logo. We won the North American Lego Contest and the Boston Lego Contest because of Dottie. This year, she co-authored our P21 application for 21st century school leadership and co-authored an MLI on the future of technology at Meadowbrook. Dottie, you model for all of us excitement for learning, love of children, and excellence. You literally reinvent yourself every 5 years, and our children are the beneficiaries of your passion. Congratulations on being recognized by your peers and for receiving this award.
Awesome. That's a word I would describe this person. Not just as a person, but also as a middle school head, and also as a leader, and also as somebody who inspires all of us to do our best every day. It is my pleasure to introduce Brendan Margay.
Thank you, and good morning, everyone. He's much better at it than I, but that is just not acceptable. Good morning, everyone. Thank you, much better. Welcome to this year's awards assembly. As I sat down to think about what I wanted to say this year, often I'll look back on years past to see what I've used in the past. And last year, the 8th grade musical was Alice in Wonderland, which is the story of a child's journey and many lessons she learns along the way. And I thought, man, what a great metaphor and how convenient that is. And so I turned to this year's musical and decided that probably wasn't the best option. So rather than make any connections there, I figured I'd go back a bit farther on behalf of this year's class for a series of simple memories. Tasting snowflakes, the sound of a page turning in a book, the warmth of sunshine, the sound of rain, the smell of sizzling bacon. I have no doubt that the class of 2014 remembers this list of simple moments in the life that can go so often unappreciated, or at least unrecognized for their simple elegance, wonder, and joy. For those of you who are wondering where they came from, they were the subtle ideas that found their way to the end of this class's production of Our Town as 7th grade students, placed along the back wall of their set as reminders for us all to take notice once in a while of the little things. But I wouldn't be surprised if some of you in this audience, particularly you students, thought that they might be something else altogether. If you thought in some way that those things that this fine group of soon-to-be graduates had come up with was a list of memories crafted throughout their journey here at Meadowbrook. How easy would it be for all of us to add some of the simple things that we have learned and experienced along our way to this moment, to this day? The stickiness of paper mache on a balloon destined to become a mask of the favorite character. The smell of gummy bears emanating from a correctly guessed estimation jar. The first plucked note of a guitar at a coffee house. the vibrant color of anticipation painted by a third grade waiting for their first visitors to the cultural fair. It may be in the sound of laughter from the audience that another political satire deftly woven into the fifth grade play, the daffodil that reminds us that spring is here. A child's effort to catch his breath after another round of Zumba. The crunch of the first picked apple at Honeypot Orchard. Or the anticipating buzz of the crowd under the lights. Or perhaps, as it was this morning, it is the first clap of one child starting a round of applause that would somehow help you to find your seat. These are the moments, shared with one another and singular to our own unique experience, that have helped shape the young people who have gathered here. But these are to be honored, but these are also the moments that we have all enjoyed this year, together as members of a community, students, teachers, and parents alike, because they draw us together and remind us of the power of little things. So I would ask you all to take a moment of your own and think about the back wall of your own personal set. What would you capture from this year? What are those moments? Throughout the Meadowbrook school year, these moments abound, and it is only when we take the time to think on them and that we come to recognize their significance. And it may be, as you think of your own moments, that you recognize one of the consistencies about them, the presence of your Meadowbrook faculty and their guiding hand. For each singular moment you've had with them, and for the sum total of your time at Meadowbrook, please, students, join me now in applauding your Meadowbrook faculty for all of their efforts on all of our behalf. Simple moments of discovery have been there, waiting for each of you. And as you sit here today, I encourage you to think of these moments, those risks you took, the moments of challenge and joy as a scholar, an athlete, an artist, a friend, and as a community member, your year has been made of them, beautiful for their simplicity and invaluable for their significance. And now it is our turn to congratulate you for another incredible year. Each year in mathematics and in the foreign languages, prizes are awarded to those students who achieve the highest level of their respective disciplines. This morning, we're excited to add a discipline to that list. So before we hear from Ms. Riegelhoff, Mr. Canfield, or Mr. Christensen to present on foreign languages and math, it is my great honor to invite Ms. Roseanne Beard to present the Boston Globe Scholastic Art Awards. Ms. Beard.
Globe Scholastic Art Awards are the regional division of a prestigious national competition that recognizes outstanding achievement in the visual arts in various forms for students in grades 7 through 12. It is presented and juried by the School of the Museum of Fine Arts in Boston. Gold, silver, and honorable awards are presented. Despite the early December deadline for finished work, I was not surprised to hear that the following five students were awarded honorable keys this year. I would like to read their names and ask them to come up to the stage to be recognized for their achievements. Isabel Seaman, two honorable keys in drawing, fashion mixed media. Deborah Hahn, for an honorable key in fashion and mixed media. Caroline Eck, for an honorable key in fashion and mixed media. Audrey Boris for an honorable key in fashion and mixed media, and Alexandra Weinstein, grade 7, for a key, an honorable key in mixed media. Excuse me, in my nervousness, the librarian Audrey Boris did not win an honorable key. That was Ashley Boris. My deep apologies, Ashley.
Yeah, and in so many ways, you have provided for us, your teachers, your parents, your grandparents, friends, those wonderfully simple moments throughout your time here. In your own unique way, you as a class have reminded us of the power of kindness as buddies to younger classes. You've shown us that truly no one actually needs to come to town if you want to see a circus. And you've shared your joy and danced with us on a bus ride in Costa Rica. You've led our school with compassion, resilience, respect, and love. This, of course, is the long way of saying that our discussion of awards for this class was a remarkable challenge. Find within a graduating class full of worthy recipients those students who have not only succeeded at the highest levels in their given discipline, but have brought with that achievement a certain passion, dedication, and love for their work. The Meadowbrook School Awards are given each year to a select number of students, chosen by the faculty, as those who have not only met Meadowbrook's standard of excellence, but have succeeded in redefining that excellence for future Meadowbrook students so that they may strive to meet it. The first of these awards, the Dorothy B. Marsh English Award, will be presented by Ryan Thomasev to Sydney Kim.
Marsh English Award is awarded to Sydney Megan Kim. The Dorothy B. Marsh English Award is presented to Sydney Megan Kim for her genuine love and aptitude for reading and writing. Sydney has an incredibly mature understanding of how language is used to entertain, to move, and to change. She sees the world as a poet sees the world. Her perception of our day-to-day existence is sharp, and she is particularly aware of how the small moments in life can hold special meaning and significance. Sydney is a creative writer at heart, and she uses both her intellect and imagination to craft truly beautiful works of prose and verse. We have no doubt that Sydney's considerable literary accomplishments here at Meadowbrook are merely a prologue to what she will accomplish in the future. Congratulations.
Taylor Mathematics Award will be presented by Mr. Canfield to Tegan Seltzer.
The Marion Taylor Taft Mathematics Award is awarded to Tegan Samantha Seltzer. The Marion Taft Taylor Mathematics Award is presented to Tegan Samantha Seltzer for her deep passion in the world of mathematics. Tegan has tirelessly sought to improve her mathematical skills during her tenure at Meadowbrook, taking advantage of every opportunity to expand her knowledge and expertise. With genuine and infectious enthusiasm, Tegan demonstrated her love of mathematics in her classes and with our math competition teams, emerging as a strong team leader, supporting and inspiring her teammates to greater levels of success and camaraderie. In addition, Tegan is able to see her world mathematically and use this insight productively, from creating technically precise and beautiful visual art to expressing the value of each day as a mathematical ratio after journaling during the Costa Rica cultural exchange. We have indeed valued every day Tegan has shared with Meadowbrook, approximately 540 out of 27,000, or 2% of her expected life. And we will miss her absolutely. Congratulations.
Presented by Ms. Riegelhaupt to Ben Fong.
The Foreign Language Award is awarded to Benjamin Thomas LaFont. An exemplary Latin student, Ben has led the charge in class, serving as a role model with his enthusiasm for the language and culture of the Romans. His Herculean achievements over the years have included earning 3 straight perfect scores on the National Latin Exam. However, Ben's passion for languages are not limited to Room 201. A true linguist in every sense of the word, Ben has shared his joy with those in the German elective, as well as with his other teachers. His interest in linguistics resonates in much of what he researches and explores. It has been said that to understand one language, you must understand at least 2. Well, in Ben's case, that would be 3 or 4. We have all learned a great deal from his discoveries, and I am confident that Ben will continue to make connections with cultures and languages throughout his high school years and beyond.
The Margaret H. Hahn Visual Arts Award will be presented by Roseanne Beer to Alexandra Gorman.
Multidimensional talents in all forms of the visual arts. Whether in drawing, painting, woodworking, ceramics, or mixed media, Alexandra has displayed her dynamic talents and confident approach in every form of creative expression. Alexandra has found a way with each medium to lead us into a creative vision built on a true belief in her work. Alexandra's vision becomes our vision, and it rings true to all who have the pleasure to enjoy the view. Is a double. Deborah S. Hahn. Deborah S. Hahn is awarded the Margaret Honig Hahn Visual Arts Award for her outstanding creative work in the field of visual arts. Deborah has excelled in drawing and painting, combining her superb natural talents and gifts with a passion for precision and detail that is truly exceptional. She works carefully and thoughtfully to make her creative images come to life before our eyes. While honing in on the finer points, Deborah never loses sight of the big picture. as she also produces work with an extraordinary sense of space, depth, and most of all, her own personal touch.
The Athletic Award will be presented by Michael Snoddy for Rena Brawl.
The Athletic Award is awarded to Karana Jade Rod. Karana Jade Rod is awarded the Athletic Award for her tireless work ethic, extraordinary athletic talent, and impeccable sportsmanship. The hardest working player at practice and in games, Karana is a galvanizing leader who consistently works to build team camaraderie and culture while promoting the development of each team player. Karana is the quintessential captain, as she maturely balances her own exceptional drive and passionate determination to improve and compete at the highest level with a desire to celebrate the success of her teammates by giving them space to shine. Karana graduates as an outstanding 9-time varsity player and 3-time captain who has grown as an athlete in skill and intelligence through each season. Her countless accomplishments, inspiring leadership, and infectious enthusiasm will be long remembered as she leaves behind a powerful legacy of metal. Congratulations.
I would like to invite Mr. Hines back for a brief announcement regarding our next award.
Never mind.
Sorry, bud. The Citizenship Award, before we get to Mr. Pines' announcement, will be presented by David Canfield to Luke Holland.
The Citizenship Award is presented to Luke Benedict Collins for the enthusiastic, inclusive, and joyous manner with which he engages in all aspects of school life. Luke brings a potent mix of scholarship and cheerfulness to the classroom each day, working well with any partner and modeling an unabashed love of learning and discovery and successfully balancing joy with respect. One of the few two-time cross-country captains, Luke's teammates appreciated more than his fine ability. They admired the pride and humility he showed as a top runner and his universal support for all teammates, regardless of ability. Indeed, Luke's universal appreciation of others is one of his most clearly defining characteristics, marking his outstanding leadership as a citizen, uniting and motivating us all. Congratulations.
Our next Citizenship Award. This Citizenship Award is awarded to Caroline DuPont Eck. The Citizenship Award is presented to Caroline DuPont Eck for her sincere dedication to the betterment of others. Whether by greeting all with a cheerful hello in the morning or devoting countless hours to the work of Cradles to Crayons, it seems that Caroline's understanding of citizenship is as robust as the service to which she is so deeply committed. A caring friend, community servant, and global activist, Caroline and her powerful voice are only gaining strength and we have every confidence that others will follow her compassionate and gracious lead. Maya Angelou once noted that people will forget what you say, people will forget what you did, but people will never forget how you made them feel. There are a few students who have worked as hard to make others feel as good as Caroline, and we will never forget her many contributions to Medicare.
Mr. Largan.
Would you care to speak, Mr. Hines?
What I would like to do is to acknowledge this is a community of scholars. We have an incredible amount of scholarship in this school, don't we? Applause to everybody. I think it's just amazing. Liz, I'm sorry I'm not available to tutor you in math. Scholarship. For me, it means excellence in learning, and it means excellence in teaching. And that requires a role model that shows us all how to be a learner of excellence and a teacher of excellence. One person comes to mind. When you think about scholarship, you need to think about Barbara T. Vincent. The faculty unanimously voted to name the Scholar Award in Barbara's name. From this moment forward in all of history, it will be called the Barbara T. Vincent Scholar Award. Barbara.
So, for the first time under its new title, it is my great pleasure to announce that the Barbara T. Vincent Scholar Award will be presented by Sarah Riegelhaupt to Elizabeth So.
Vincent Scholar Award is awarded to Elizabeth Jane Soe. The Scholar Award is awarded to Elizabeth Jane Soe for her impressively flawless transcript, an inspirational commitment to academics and the arts. Socrates once wrote, "Education is the kindling of a flame, not the filling of a vessel." Indeed, there's a spark in Lizzie that shines brightly. Her passion for learning has never wavered in her years at Meadowbrook. Simultaneously a pillar of expertise on the math team, while also expressing herself articulately in writing or even in a foreign language, there has been no limit to her aptitude and achievement in all things academic and artistic. Lizzie will surely achieve unimaginable success as she tackles each new challenge with her undeniable traits as a journal scholar. We all look forward to learning of her many accomplishments in the decades.
Is awarded to Isaac Lee Blackburn Johnson. The Faculty Award is presented to Isaac Lee Blackburn Johnson. Isaac has distinguished himself across the board, not only as a dedicated scholar and determined athlete, but also as a leader among his peers and a role model for younger students. Mr. Meadowbrook, Isaac is always proud to sport a Meadowbrook jersey, to promote the school as a tour guide and ambassador, and to represent this community outside of our doors as a compassionate traveler. His personal passions and interests, particularly for political history and world languages, reflect an inspiration nurtured throughout his 10 years at Meadowbrook, and a sincere commitment to make positive changes in the world. A deep thinker, an empathic listener, and a student of life, Isaac represents the best of what Meadowbrook has to offer.
They say it takes a village to raise a child, but what if the child raises a village? In only 3 short years, Ashley has simultaneously grown as a learner and taught us important lessons of her own in humility, resilience, and joy. She has learned that every question and answer can delve deeper and mean more, and she has taught us that there is limitless depth to the human spirit. She has learned that education is not limited to textbooks or equations, while teaching us that wisdom does not reside exclusively within adults. She has learned that Meadowbrook is both a school for the mind as well as a school for the soul, while sharing with us the impact of what a truly good soul can do for a community. Thank you, Ashley, for all that you have shared with us. Congratulate all award recipients and indeed all students for their success after another great year at the Meadowbrook School. Congratulations. After a morning spent in the blazing spotlights on stage, it is my pleasure to dismiss the faculty who have graciously seated themselves up here. Thank you. We will drop the screen because the time has come for the 8th grade video. Thank you very much. Thus concludes everything but for our graduates, the important stuff tomorrow morning. We are so grateful to you as parents, as friends, as grandparents, and as teachers for all that you students have shared with us over the course of this year. We hope that you have a fabulous, wonderful summer of joy and relaxation and discovery. And we'd like to thank you all for coming to the 2014 Awards Day Assembly. Thank you very much.